Hi everyone, welcome to another interview from our interview series with successful business analysis practitioners. Today we will be interacting with Anshu Tandon, and she has cracked CBAP recently and in just 2 months and through the self-learning course. So let's understand Anshu's journey in her own words. Hi Anshu, how are you?
Hi Nitin, thank you. I'm good.
So let's start with that. Let's talk about yourself. Let's talk about your professional background before we jump on to how you prepared for CBAP.
Sure. So to introduce myself, I have been working as a business analyst in IT industry for almost like more than 13 years, and I have primarily worked in the BFSI domain. And I have started my career as an automation expert. But then within 2 years, I moved into business analyst role. I was lucky enough to get that chance, and that's how my business analyst journey started. And in between this journey, I did my many certifications, which let me become a successful BA. And currently, I'm working in Canada in an IT company, and I'm happy working there.
Awesome. Why CBAP, Anshu? I mean, there are so many certifications available. Since you're based out of Canada, so was that the calling that, because you know IIBA is based in Canada, so was that the calling or was it something else? Because there are many institute who conduct many kind of certifications. So why CBAP?
Yeah, you are right. That is one of the reason, because I was seeing CBAP keyword in most of the job description. And I was curious to know what is this course, so I thought, okay, let's give it a try. And that's how I reached here. But here in Canada, we have like in some of the job requirements, you have a prerequisite that you need to be CBAP. So that's why having a CBAP was an additional advantage for being a BA.
Awesome. Just for our audience, CBAP is conducted by IIBA, which is International Institute of Business Analysis. The institute itself is in Toronto, Canada. So yeah. So how was your preparation? Let's talk about your preparation. You just cracked CBAP in 2 months, and it's kind of an achievement in itself because CBAP is a really tough examination. I mean, it's the certification for business analysis. So let's talk about your preparation now.
So everything started with just a thought, because I was seeing the CBAP word long ago, but I never thought of doing it by myself. So in September 2023, I thought maybe I should give it a try just for the application purpose, whether I'm eligible or not, because I like previously there was some gap in my career. So I thought, let's give it a try just for the application. And if it get approved, then I will move to the next step. So in September 2023, I filled the form by myself, and then I realized that I need to have the PDUs. So just to get the PDUs, I searched online who are the endorsed providers, education provider with IIBA. So I found the Tech Canvas name, and that's how I connected with the team. And the team was really helpful, and they, when I enrolled with them for the self-learning course to get my PDUs, they helped me in filling the form, guiding how to do. And the course material also, like they shared a lot of things, the recording material and the course itself. And I was got a chance to attend some doubt clearing sessions as well. And this everything helped me a lot going in my 2 months preparation. But my journey started from September 2023 when I filled the form. And by last week of September, my application got approved. And when it got approved, so ideally I was supposed to start my preparation from October. But due to some other, because I'm a working professional, so there were some other commitments as well. So I started it properly from November 2023.
Awesome. So, I mean, I always say this, every candidate's success is team success. So we are really happy for you. Any challenges which you want to talk about? You did speak about, you know, the commitments which you had before starting the preparation. Any other challenge which you want to talk about while you were preparing for this exam?
So when I was preparing for exam, I had like the first thing was I had some other prior commitments which were scheduled since long months. So I had to focus on that as well. So that was the one thing. Second thing was like when I started reading Babok, Even earlier also, I had seen Babok, like the IIBA website, the content that there is something called Babok and we have to go, the PAs usually refer, especially if you go for any interview. It is, I would say, even though you are doing the CBAC or not, but just go to the Babok because that gives you more understanding of how questions they ask, like what are different techniques, right? So eliciting, like that helps in the interviews as well. So I had seen some content, like just I've heard about it that okay, there is something for Babok one, but when I actually started reading the book, I got the access. I was surprised. It was so detailed. In the real world, we never thought that this is the actual step we are doing. But when it was like going through the each page, it feels like okay, this is the name of the step which we do in the real world. It was now a
Correct.
linking that what we do, because sometimes we don't know the names, but we are just following the things, right? So reading through Babok was a challenge thing, because when I was reading, I could not recall everything. So I went through the recordings and I attended the session, but when I was going through the Babok, it was hard to like to remember the steps, to remember the things. What are the tasks, what are the inputs, elements, right? So for that, I practiced a lot. And when I say it was more than 180 hours, and you can understand like in 2 months, giving so much time for application filing at that time, I did I think some around 1 week thing, but still 1 week was just to get the PDUs, right? So it was on fast track course, but remembering these and practicing these, it was a challenging because I was not able to recall and remember everything. And I know some people use mnemonics to learn the input, output, and guidelines. But I was not. I thought to put it the actual effort, and I did it the hard way. So what I did was I actually linked everything. I tried to do practice to remember the full names, based on the input, output. So input, output, we know. It was easy to remember. Task name, I practiced like to remember. Then the elements, because I was reading the book all the time, so I remembered. I was reading to based on the knowledge areas mostly. So I revisited the knowledge areas multiple times, and as a result, I remember the elements. And when you remember the elements, it is very easy to link the guidelines. Like what with the guideline, because the element is this, so you know the guidelines. So that really was a challenging thing, and because of that, it took me a lot of time. And because I was practicing a lot, so I used other sources as well. Like I used one app which was about the application, the for exam, so the practice questions. So I used that on app mobile. So wherever I go, if I have time, I just switch on the net and do the practice. Or with Tech Canvas, we have the study materials, the session recording. So I would go through those. I would like to highlight one thing that with Tech Canvas, what I found useful was about the keywords for the techniques. So if you do study by yourself, you don't know what are the keywords, there is any other way to learn, right? So because I started from myself first, so that's why I tried to do the things. I didn't use the shortcuts. Yep. So I would like to highlight one thing. During the recording sessions, I heard in one of the sessions from Satisha that there are some keywords for the techniques. And then I was more curious to know what are these keywords. And then I connected again to Tech Canvas team to get more information. And based on the recordings, so I got some new recordings shared again. And in those recordings, they were talking about the keywords. So it was they talked only about the generic keywords, but I understood that there is something about the keyword thing, right? So what I did was because I was practicing through multiple sources. Like Tech Canvas test questions, practice questions, plus there were some online questions as well, which I was doing. So I would say like I had done more than 3,000 questions, practice questions overall. I practiced, and as a result, what happened was that in my actual exam, I appeared for the online version of the exam, and it took me. So I was supposed to log in 30 minutes before the exam. I logged in, but the whole process, the verification process, took more than 30 minutes. So I would say it took me around like 38 minutes, and I got that anxiety that it's taking my exam time, right? But still, I completed my exam. I can say exactly at 2 hours, or just like 5 minutes plus 2 hours. So, and the reason was that in the actual exam also, because I was now familiar with the keywords, right? And which I practiced by myself. So I prepared my notes like for the keywords. So I didn't prepare anything, but through practicing, it was in my head that okay, what are the keywords, right? So just identifying those questions, I was able to just put it. So in my first hour of the exam, I was actually able to go through all the questions. So I could scan through all the questions, and whatever I didn't know, I just flagged it. And then in the next hour, I worked on the flagged questions. So I think I would appreciate myself for that speed, because and that obviously came from the practice, because I practiced so hard that I was able to answer the real time questions which were in the exam. So I would say
Awesome.
that for techniques, everyone should remember the keywords. And I have shared with some of the people who were there in my study group about the 40, almost for 40 techniques I had shared. For 10, they are like they are standard ones, so you have to figure it out. But ultimately, after 40, you can find out the technique keywords.
Awesome. More than, I mean, you said you practice more than
3,000 questions.
3,000 questions. That's a lot.
Actually, I wanted to pass in the very first attempt, so I was determined. So I put extra hours, and I took some vacation time as well, like so-called vacation time, which was actually for studying, and only studying. And my
Got it.
family was actually my parents visited us, so because of that, I was after office. I was having some time, like after office, I was only studying.
I can understand. Bibok is 500-page book, which Bibok stands for Business Analysis Body of Knowledge for our viewers, information for our viewers. It's a 500-plus page book. It becomes quite overwhelming. There are many keywords which people might not understand when they are reading it for the first time. So, but you did a great job. And cracking it in 2 months is not easy. Definitely, if you sweat more in training, you will be able to achieve the goal which you are aiming for. So I know you have shared quite a few tips with us how to go about for this examination. Any more tips which you want to highlight before we close this?
I would like to highlight that when I started my preparation, right? So in the very first few weeks, I would also just to solve Tech Canvas chapter-wise question, right? Which are exactly like 10 questions. It took take me like 30 minutes or sometimes even 40 minutes just to go through in the initial stages, just the 10 question. So I realized that speed is one of the key in the exam, because I was overheading many times that it's 3.5 hour, but it also less time, right? Considering the question. So my main focus was always on the time, like how I can reduce my time, right? So even though I was learning everything, I didn't use any mnemonic, right? Everything was in my head. So I knew by heart what is the input of this task, how to recognize the keyword for that task. I could understand based on the question, and then I remember the output input. So I didn't have to refer anything. So even in the exam also, I didn't use any, like I didn't write anything on the paper actually, because I didn't need anything to write. Everything was there, and I learned it by heart, you can say, or I remembered it by heart. But everything was practice. So what I mean to say, like initial test 10 questions took me like 30 minutes, and then later on by practicing only I reduced my speed. So even in the when I attempted my very first Tech Canvas full examination, the test one, I was able to do that in 1.5 hours. So and that too was it was very quick. So I already knew in my mind that when I will be actually appearing for the exam, I don't need 3.5 hours. I was confident for that. However, I was having that nervousness that what will come in the exam, you know, because sometimes case studies are very confusing. So however, but still I would say that if you have practiced a lot, then there is lot of chance that you will be passing in one attempt with understanding. It's not just I did some trial, right? It's something I knew by practice. I remembered it. So when I said it 3,000 question, because of these 3,000 question, what happened was that if anyone was talking about any element or anything, then I remembered, okay, this is from that page, because that is that chapter, because this is the knowledge area and this is the element in that task, right? So I know I practice, I put lot of time. It is not feasible for everyone to put that much effort. And I would say I practice too much, so I won't recommend everyone to practice so much. But still, if you are doing 2,000 question, you are good in a good position to do the things. And it depends on your wish and your determination, how you are ready to put the efforts, right?
Yeah. Thank you for sharing this wonderful journey, a journey which was full of a lot of hard work, a lot of practice, a lot of determination, and there are so many other adjectives which I can add to it. But yeah, hats off to your perseverance, which made you achieve this goal. It was great talking to you, and all the best for your career.
Thank you.
And yeah, it was great talking to you again. Thank you.